Don't play another shot, don't play another practice session and another game until you've seen this video, because what I'm going to say in this video might just change everything. Yes, indeed, it's a bold statement, and I try not to make bold statements. But I think if you follow this video and hopefully get where my mind is when I'm creating this video, you might just agree and you might get something out of it. How many times have we missed shots that we really shouldn't have missed? This video isn't about the individual things that we've done wrong to miss that shot. This video is about the baseline that covers everything from playing the shot, from learning how to play the shot, from improving in this game quickly or slowly. What we're going to look at is discipline and the major part that that plays across the board. So let's look at the importance of discipline. The importance on how it affects us learning to play snooker and, of course, playing snooker. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to reverse this, and I want to show you what happens when we're undisciplined. What I've been doing when I've been playing and practicing more undisciplined than disciplined, and how that has affected my learning and my game. So people, if you like what you're seeing in these videos, please hit the like button and hit the subscribe button. And when you do, leave me a comment down below and where you're from, and we'll get you on the snooker shed door, just like Q Sports Yorkshire. That's Rebecca Kenner, who's just got herself a 2-year pro card. So keep your eyes out this season for Rebecca. And thanks very much for watching. So this is my dog, Bailey. He's an English Springer Spaniel, and he's wired to the moon. And in Scotland, we would say he's daft as a brush. So where does this relate to snooker? Well, when Bailey was a pup, I would think of Bailey as our subconscious mind and what we are trying to teach in snooker. Hey, son. And if I was to give Bailey, when he was a pup, inconsistent commands and inconsistent teaching to cross the road, then he would find it extremely difficult to reproduce that when asked. But if we stay disciplined and we make sure that Bailey knew the same commands, he knew the tone of my voice, he knew where to sit and where I would stand, when to cross the road and how to cross the road, what pace we were going to go across, then he would be able to do it successfully much, much quicker. Hey boy, good lad. So now if we put that into snooker terms, and if we're practicing and we're undisciplined, what are we teaching our dogs or our subconscious? We're teaching it mixed signals. So if you look at the pre-shot for routine, for instance, if you stand in a different place each time, what are you telling yourself? What are you telling your subconscious to do? It's going to do exactly what you're teaching it. It doesn't know if it's right or wrong. It just repeats what you're doing. And if your discipline isn't correct and you constantly tell your brain to do some good things and some bad things, then when we're playing our matches and we're allowing our subconscious to take over, so we're concentrating on the shot rather than the technique and the pre-shot routine as such, then what happens is it's a bit of a mixed bag and you end up playing some good shots and some bad shots. And that's based on what you've told your brain what to do when you've been practicing and learning how to play the game undisciplined. Or we could say the game undisciplined. Hey son, hey good boy. So I reckon I'm playing round about 2 hours every day, somewhere around about that if I can, and maybe a wee bit more at the weekends. Think about how many hours I'll play in a year. But then when I was thinking about this video, I started to think how many hours actually have been good, disciplined hours that were teaching my brain the correct way, and how many hours was reckless and undisciplined and doing the exact opposite. So what I'm saying is, from now on, practice with that super discipline. And I'm just going to give you a quick example of what I mean by making sure you're practicing with discipline so that your brain's getting the correct information while you learn how to play the game. Right, so a quick wee shot that I've been practicing. To make these bigger breaks, what I've noticed is that I'm lacking in cannons and the correct place to cannon. So what I'm practicing here is a shot off the black with two reds where I need to cannon them and hopefully be able to pop one to continue the break. So the super discipline in this shot is the pre-shot routine and making sure that I'm going to strike the black the same place every time. Maybe not the cue ball, because that's what's moving towards the reds, but definitely the black. I need to make sure I'm standing in the same place and I'm delivering the cue in the same way every time. Because if there's inconsistencies coming, standing differently, aiming differently, then what's happening is the results will be inconsistent. And that's then teaching my brain something that's inconsistent. I don't want to do that. I want to learn that striking the cue ball at the black and hitting it in that particular place on the cue ball comes back and hits the reds. Then I could adjust where I'm hitting in each shot to get the desired effect. So that's discipline and learning and how it works. Let's look at discipline and how the learning part transitions into discipline in a frame. And for me, it's all about the pre-shot routine, because if we play a shot good, normally your pre-shot routine has been good and solid. If we've missed the ball, balls that you know you really shouldn't have, normally it's because you've not done something correct in the pre-shot routine. And that goes back to the practice. Remembering that the pre-shot routine practice, if it's inconsistent, when you go to play the shot, those inconsistencies come back and creep in and bite you. So when I'm playing frames now, I'm still having to focus on certain parts of my pre-shot routine. One of them for me is the contact point on the object ball. When I pull my cue back, I must be looking as I deliver at that contact point, or I just missed the ball. And that's never a good thing in a frame, because really you want to be focusing on the shot, and that is down to the lack of discipline. Another one that I've found creeps in every now and again, you're playing off the black into the reds to make a cannon, and you miss the simple black and make the cannon, just simply because you've taken your eye off the pot. So in essence, your game is only as good as your practice, and your practice is only as good as your discipline. Because when you have disciplined practice, your subconscious then could play naturally, and you don't have to focus on the things you shouldn't be when you're making that shot.
Hi there, my name is Ross Muir, and I'll see you on the table.